beatboxing, transforming my body into something else. Something hopefully transcendent. Yeah, music is, it's critical in a way that I'm just beginning to understand. My name is Shodekeh Talifero, and I am the innovator in residence for the College of Fine Arts and Communication here at Towson University. The title Innovator in Residence and the Responsibility means taking the vantage point of what I do as a professional musician, specifically beatboxer, vocal percussionist, breath artist, and then using that vantage point as my anchor for when I travel throughout all of the College of Fine Arts and Communication. So I might go downstairs and play music for a dance class with Eric Spangler. I might have a meeting with someone in the theater department about how we're going to use the perspective of a beatboxer in the context of a speech and dialect class. Guest lectures, performances, composition work, and then each year I do a capstone project as well. So I treat it like a fellowship. First started back in 2006, so I was playing music for a poetry event that took place every week called Slamicide. And one fateful day, Vincent Thomas is sitting in the audience. The first break of the evening, he handed me his card, introduced himself, and said, "I would love to work with you. I teach dance over at Towson University. I would love to bring you in to do some work." So I came in for a meeting, had my first class a few weeks later, and the rest is history. This relationship with this university continues to change my life on so many different levels.
Some of the first times I physically actually saw him, he was actually in Caremore. He was in the middle of the program, and the other performers were exactly what you would expect at a classical music venue right outside of New York City in the summertime. All of a sudden you hear this sound from some other place, and it's off the wing, and it's Shodekeh coming through, and you're like, oh my goodness. And it changed everything about the performance and the performers. It was a complete improvisation, and they stayed in this sonic trance. And afterwards, I think it was the head of the group said, "We didn't know what to do, but we knew what was happening was really special, and we all stayed in the moment." So it was incredible. And then, of course, Shodekeh takes the mic, and he says, "A shout-out to Baltimore and a shout-out to Towson University," and we were all, like, yelling. So we all acted differently than we normally would in a classical music venue, and it was so much fun.
I've played music for so many midterm classes, so many finals, and the dance program, the instrumentation of the body through beatboxing, the instrumentation of the body through dance, just an instant dynamic connection that occurs. Now with the Living Archive at Albert S. Cook Library here on campus, that sort of fellowship framework is just being taken to a whole nother level, because to be able to bring it into an academic setting, I feel like the work has only begun. I saw Dougie Fresh perform in Beat Street, 1985 on cable television, and then a year later, Buffy the Human Beatbox from the Fat Boys perform at Crush Groove, you know, going back to some of those driving forces behind wanting to pursue beatboxing and using the voice as an instrument as a kid. There was a lot of abuse that I experienced growing up for a long time. And having my first encounter and battle with ideation at 9, no matter what other people have done to me, at the end of the day, I'm still the only one who can get out of my own way. Like when I watch Kenny Muhammad or Dougie Fresh or Razel perform, I see transcendence when they perform on stage as beatboxers, as human instruments. I still can't believe it, but in December I'll be having my Carnegie Hall debut, not only as a performer, but as a composer for a piece of music that I wrote for the percussion ensemble, So Percussion. I'm terrified, I'm excited, I'm humbled, I'm empowered to be able to share my music on a stage that I never thought I'd ever have the opportunity to set foot on.
I see him as someone who will continue to grow and grow and grow, because he's on a hero's journey, an artistic quest that I think will last his lifetime.
referencing Buckminster Fuller's ideation epiphany of turning around from wanting to take his own life to hearing a voice from the universe saying your life is not your own, and maybe have a message to be shared through the music that's bigger than you, bigger than your debut, bigger than being a performer or a composer, to the extent that it can inspire someone else to, instead of sacrificing their life, saving their life so they can help someone else.